Well, Nick Cannon is getting his talk show with the same company as Wendy Williams, but y'all did not want to believe me, so let's talk about it. Hi, welcome to JOA. If new to my channel, please click subscribe and click the bell so you'll be the first to know when I upload. I'd really appreciate it if you subscribe and you click the bell. If you're new to my channel, I appreciate it. Hello, I'm JOA. I'm an unfiltered person. I ask icebreaker questions to get to know my viewers. I like to connect with you guys. I'm very personal. So where are you from? What is your talent? What is your purpose in life? What do you do that makes you extraordinary? What is your competitive advantage? What sets you apart from the next person? Let me know in the comments below. I appreciate your commentary on that. So Nick Cannon made some harsh comments towards the Jewish community, and he was backlashed to the point where he even had suicidal tweets on his Twitter. So then he backtracked, sent an apology tweet, and it still didn't help him because he was just basically saying the black community is against him and he can't win on either side. And a lot of people were worried about him from that tweet. So he invited a rabbi to his podcast to explain this stuff. So the rabbi pretty much explained the history and the ins and outs of the Jewish community and how the Jews basically are, you know, persecuted with anti-Semitism throughout Europe and even, according to Barry Wise, coming to the United States and according to other Jewish scholars that writes about it in the news, there's anti-Semitism here. And so by Nick Cannon bringing that rabbi on the show, by Nick Cannon actually working with Barry Wise and buying her book, and she needs the job. And y'all know I'm not a fan of Barry Wise. If you watch my channel, the girl that does The View sometimes, Meghan McCain's best friend. And that's because during college years, Miss Barry Wise tried to get a Palestinian professor fired because she thought that his ideology is different from hers. And so I don't know if y'all know, that's a personal thing for me, not because it's wrong, because if I wasn't Palestinian, I still would make it wrong. But as a Palestinian first generation American, the fact that, you know, people come here to get a great opportunity and you're trying to take away from that man because his ideology is different from yours is really not really nice, Barry Wise. So I won't be JOA if I didn't say this on the camera with a lot of you guys watching. Yes, I do agree there's anti-Semitism here. There's anti-Semitism overseas as well. But in reality, there's also anti-Semitism towards Palestinians in Palestine till this day. They're being mistreated illegally. They're not allowed to cross barriers. There's an actual wall. If you're born on the West Bank, you can't go to the East Bank and vice versa. There's limited electricity, limited education. So let's be 100% real here. Let's demolish the anti-Semitism, and let's also demolish the Palestinian illegal human rights and actually treat them like humans and give them full access to both sides and not let them be like me, because you have to be an American in order to have access to all over the Palestinian side and Israeli side. I'm sorry, I had to say it. I'm not Nick Cannon. I'm going to say what I have to say. But Palestinians deserve full rights in Palestine. And unfortunately, that's also deemed anti-Semitic in mainstream media. But I don't care. I'm saying it on here. So this video is not really about her, but she presented a book to Nick Cannon, and while she do needs the job because her career is playing the victim like Meghan McCain, she left New York Times because she was playing the victim saying she was bullied. And so she pinned a tweet of Nick Cannon announcing that he bought her book to further educate himself on the Jewish community, because on her bio till this day, it still says she needs a job. And my whole art opinion as being around black people, literally from the day I was born to the age of 28 years old, a lot of my friends were black. I may not look black, but I'm familiar with the culture. I'm 100% sure that the comments that Nick Cannon made was 100% his feelings. What is the Dr. Maya Angelou quote? If they show you, I'm paraphrasing here, but help me out in the comments. If they show you who you are the first time, believe them. I'm not saying that Nick Cannon views it and changed. What I'm saying is he has a talk show by Debmar Mercury, and a leading affiliate group is Fox. And y'all know with Fox comes with the certain things in the Fox category with the news, the Trumpsters. So, of course, Nick Cannon has to backtrack and, you know, try to establish some type of agenda, his leverage with the apology, along with his apology by inviting a rabbi and, you know, getting affiliated with Barry Wise because he needs his talk show. His talk show with Debmar Mercury, the people who have Wendy Williams under their wing and Steve Harvey Family Feuds, did not drop Nick Cannon, which is they actually, what they did was they furthered the talk show year back quietly because they did not want to drop him. You know, they felt his apology was sincere and they do need a further replacement for Wendy Williams down the line, because at the moment, you know, she says that everything is okay. And in her documentary, she says that nothing's wrong with her, but we all know there's something up here. Like she says to Mariah and Britney Spears, that she has as well. So Nick Cannon apologized, but before he apologized, not only was his talk show pushed back, but he was canceled overnight. His Masked Singer job was on the line. He lost Wildin' Out and he lost his other shows. Now everything is coming back to him very vivaciously. And now he fell in line with the industry. And here's two things. You can either be a Monique, you could be either for the integrity game, or you could be a Steve Harvey for a money game. So he chose the Steve Harvey route and fall in line to the people of the line, the mastermind, the Fox group, and the Debmar Mercury group. Because y'all know, a lot of people don't say this, and I know, because, I mean, at the end of the day, they are my brothers and sisters, but the Jews, a lot of them, they own the entertainment industry, just like my people. We in the gas stations and the clothing stores and the taxi cab service. So Nick Cannon had to fall in line with what he said and take back what he said, although deep down, I'm sure, like Maya Angelou quote, he basically meant what he said, but he needed his money. Not only because he needed his money, but also because he keep producing babies and different side chicks. You know, he left the beautiful Mariah Carey. Now he got this other woman. He got pregnant. God knows who in the future. I'm sorry, you guys, with that sound. God knows who in the future what he would do with the baby making. So his show is going to air in the fall of 2021, which is really not too far from right now. You know, I'm actually really proud of Wendy Williams, because a lot of people thought that she wouldn't get her act together with the whole divorce and with the whole alleged relapse and everything. And she really pulled herself together. I still believe there's stuff wrong behind the scenes that her team is not addressing. Because, I mean, they went through 12 years of hell, and a lot of them, they're still there, like the Norman Baker, the Suzanne Bass, Suzanne's husband, and a lot of people, other people behind the scenes are still there, and they tolerated with the antics with the husband that Wendy had. And I'm still, like DJ Booth said, there's things going on, and they're scared to address it to Wendy because they're scared to lose their job. So I'm sure there's things going on behind the scenes. But I do remember in the interview that Wendy did describe, and I also remember in the past that she said she doesn't want to be on TV for a long time. And at first, with her antics, I was thinking that Debmar Mercury is going to slowly transition her off the TV and slowly have Nick Cannon on for maybe a year while Wendy's on, kind of give Wendy that main show and give Nick Cannon the hook for promotion, and then afterwards, you know, slowly just have her retire, have her be behind the scenes or do something else. And so that's what I think what's really going to happen. I don't think Wendy Williams is going to be pushed out, because I, you know, she's smarter than you think. But I also believe that Nick Cannon show was pushed back after he made those comments because Debmar Mercury believes in his talent, Nick Cannon's talent, and they believe that he could be the one that could garnish the attention that Wendy Williams till this day, after 10 plus years, is garnishing on her talk show. Now, I'm not going to lie, although Wendy Williams have her problems mentally, if I was in school and she would have been a professor, an adjunct professor, an adjunct instructor, I would surely take her class, because it wouldn't be a waste of money with the connections and with the stories that she can tell, with how she'd handle the industry, versus taking a professor that only wants you to study the book and have a test, and they never went into a studio to hold a mic or even talked in front of the camera. So with Wendy Williams being an adjunct instructor, baby, sign me up today. Please, I'm still young enough to go to school. Sign me up. So Nick Cannon, they decided that they wanted to have a show with him, Debmar Mercury, after he took Wendy's place while she was dealing with her Graves' disease and her husband trauma, now do we know, although I knew already, but still. And he did really well in ratings. You know, Wendy Williams could have had a chance in being a say in this and could have actually got an actual stream of income from this, but she decided to give a white man that acts like a black woman, Jerry O'Connell, a show saying, "How you doing?" and acting like a Wendy Williams. And it did not work so well. So what Nick Cannon did, instead of going to Wendy formally and saying, hey, can you talk to your bosses and see if we can pull a show together? He knew there was a line of trust there, because if y'all all remember, when NeNe Leakes was popping back in the day, Kevin Hunter allegedly pulled the plug on NeNe Leakes' show with Debmar Mercury. Until this day, NeNe Leakes, according to her interview with The Breakfast Club, do not know what really happened. So Nick Cannon is a really smart black man. Instead of going to Wendy Williams about business, and they often do talk on the phone about business. That's what their main conversations are on the phone. And they specifically said that on air. He went behind the scenes against the leans of Debmar Mercury, baby. Them Jewish people. Debmar Mercury. And they got him a talk show, because he knew that if he would have went to Wendy Williams, she would have pulled that plug, because Wendy Williams, let's keep it real, it just seems that she doesn't support her own brothers and sisters, and she doesn't want someone up there to that is the same line of ancestry as her to either be on the same line of her again in terms of talent or outdo her. So I don't know about you guys, but I'm going to actually see and give Nick Cannon a shot when his talk show comes in fall of 2021. I believe in giving people a shot. I think he is talented, and, you know, he's charismatic and he's good with the audiences, as you guys saw with his Hot Topics. Hot Topics was okay. I mean, I like Jerry Shepard's better than his, but, you know, I'm going to give him a shot, and, you know, I'm rooting for anyone that's a person of color, that's black, because till this day, we still need representation. And I can't believe, well, actually, I can't believe I'm saying that in 2021. But we need people that can watch Nick Cannon at the age of 5, a black person that can look on the television and say, hey, that could be me. That could be me. I could be the next Arsenio Hall. I could be the next Montel Williams. I could be the next Steve Harvey. And I could be the next Nick Cannon. But anyways, y'all, if you're new to my channel, come on, y'all, please click that subscribe button and click the bell, y'all. I'm entertaining. Am I? Am I entertaining? Let me know, baby. Let me know. Please do subscribe. Answer the questions, icebreaker questions I ask, and click the bell so you will be the first to know when I upload. Deuces. Yay.